Good morning. I hope you're all having a wonderful day so far. So it is Saturday right now. Saturdays are usually my full-on study days and meal prep days where I get my foods ready for the coming week. And this week's meal prep is what I'm gonna show you in this video. But before I start prepping or cooking anything though, I always need to write down my game plan first. I usually do that the night before, where I first write out everything but for the individual meals that I'll need, and then add that up to the bulk portion sizes I have to cook and meal prep for each ingredient. That just keeps everything nice and organized and so, so easy, because today, for example, I meal prep complete meals for 3 days and ingredients for 5 days, but that differs. And I like to do the full meals for only 3 days because I want to prep vegetables for only 3 days, but like to have my proteins and carbs ready already for the full week so that I don't have to worry about that anymore. Next thing then, before I actually start cooking, is I take out everything that I will need while cooking at the beginning. This means all foods and spices, but also all the bowls, spoons, pans, etc. Again, that just helps keep everything clean and organized. Then when I finally start, I like to start with breakfast first. Today I made some protein pancakes where I used a can of pumpkin, which was the first time that I used pumpkin in that recipe actually. I used 2.5 cups of egg whites, 200 grams of whole wheat flour. Last time I used oats, but I just like the taste of whole wheat flour more. I used 100 grams of blueberries, only because we had some left, otherwise I would have skipped this step. And then 280 grams of cottage cheese. And I think next time I might leave that out if I use the pumpkin, because that made the pumpkin and that together made it really, really soft, a little bit too moist. Anyway, then I also added 25 grams of chia seeds and flax seeds each. This thickens the batter nicely. Some baking powder and sweetener. Then I gave it all a good mix. And you can already see how thick the batter got. It was so, so nice. And also the chia seeds and flax seeds will thicken it even more. And that's why I set the bowl to the side for a little bit, for a minute or so, to give it some time to rest. And during that time, I cut some around 35 grams of chocolates. I cut it nice and fine. However, I like to have some bigger parts in there as well, some like chocolate chunk parts in the batter, which makes it really nice and delicious. And I'm not sure why, but I feel that cutting up the chocolates yourself is so worth it and tastes much better than just adding chocolate chips in there. Anyway, next I also added 80 grams of nuts. Any nuts that I have at home. I put them in a Ziploc bag and smashed them with a cup until they were nice and fine. This just will give the pancakes a nice crunch and some more texture. Then I added the chocolate and nuts to the bowl and mixed it thoroughly. And oh my gosh, it smelled so, so nice during that step. It is, I believe, because the dough rested a little bit. But anyway, then taking the bowl over to the stove, where I sprayed a pan with some cooking oil. It is very necessary for these pancakes because they were so moist. Last week I had 4 small pancakes per meal, which was really nice, but this time I wanted to try one huge pancake instead. So I sprayed the pan, made sure to keep the spray out, and used around 360 grams of dough per serving. And I cooked that on medium to low medium heat because of the fact that the pancakes are so thick. So they need pretty long time to cook through. And yeah, it was probably like 4 minutes, 3 to 4 minutes per side. Anyway, while doing that, also always make sure to have a small plate by your side for the dirty utensils and a big one for the ready pancakes. Again, be gentle with them. It really helps to also spray the top of the pancake with some cooking spray before turning it, because of the fact that they are just so, so fragile and fall apart easily. My first pancake actually was a complete disaster, so I didn't even film that. But the other ones turned out fine. And I did 5 pancakes here all together, and the more I made, the easier it got to turn them, to be honest. Then once the pancakes were done, I started with lunch and dinner to the same time. For lunch, I made some salmon. I usually have it frozen, and if I remember to thaw it before, I do. If not, that's fine as well. I just spray a sheet with some cooking spray and place the salmon on there. I cut it up a little bit because that helps to just bake it a little faster and also absorb the lemon juice that I drizzle on top. I also use some salt right now already. And then I bake it on 285 degrees Fahrenheit for around 20 minutes. For dinner, I made some soy burger patties from Boca. I think you say Boca. I have no idea if they taste good. We will find that out this week because it's the first time I'm having them, but I'm very optimistic. I also had some beef left over, which was perfect because I only have 4 patties, but want to prep for 5 days. So I made the patties after their instructions. I just grilled them on the pan. And for next to the salmon, I made some mashed sweet potato. I had the sweet potato frozen, just microwaved it with some milk and seasoning. And currently I use this ranch seasoning with literally everything. It's so, so good. I put that into the sweet potato until everything was nice and mixed. And then I could already start getting the meals ready, actually. So for the lunches, I have 3 meal prep containers. I reuse those, by the way, all the time, just like normal lunch boxes. I just don't warm up my food in those containers. Then, because the salmon was still really hot, I put it in a separate container for now and started adding the sweet potato mash first. I used around 1/2 cup per meal, added around 55 grams of salmon to each meal, 1/2 a bag of green beans, and some corn, carrots, and peas. And then for the dinners, I have another 3 meal prep containers and added 1/2 cup of cooked whole wheat egg noodles. I already had them prepped, and those noodles are just my favorite right now. Then I added the beef and beef patty. And for the vegetables, I added 1/2 a bag of Brussels sprouts and some carrots in each meal. And actually, that's it. You could literally stop right here. But I always like to season everything as soon as it's prepped so that I can't even forget about that before eating. So I added some salt to all the vegetables, as well as some nutritional yeast, which is so delicious. Normally I always have phases with seasonings, but nutritional yeast is the one thing that I'm using for months straight already. It's so good. And now lastly, I also wanted to take advantages and use up some of open sauces we had left in the fridge. So some meals got some Alfredo sauce, some got some salsa, and some teriyaki sauce. And that was it. That's 11 meals plus leftovers, proteins, and carbohydrates are done for the week. And it took me about an hour, I would say. Now, if you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up and let me know in the comments. And I will see you in the next one. Bye-bye.